Hi everyone, and thank you for joining us today for this Low Carbon Homes online event. My name's Andy Edwards and I'm E.ON's Eco National Sales Manager, and today I'd like to talk about the Energy Company Obligation, otherwise known as Eco, and more specifically about Eco 4, which is the energy efficiency scheme currently in operation. However, before I do that, I'd like to provide you with a brief overview of previous energy efficiency obligations and how we got to this point. So, supplier obligations have been in place for a number of years now, and were firstly introduced in 2004 through an Act of Parliament, namely the Energy Efficiency Obligation Order. And this effectively required larger energy companies like E.ON to provide funding to support energy efficiency initiatives. Now, the first scheme that was introduced back in 2005, and this was the Energy Efficiency Commitments. This was followed by CERT in 2008, and then the first, second and third phases of Eco. Now, each of these obligations have focused on low cost energy efficiency measures, so things like loft, cavity wall and also gas boilers predominantly, and they've been really successful in deploying those measures at scale. But the one thing they haven't done is address the problem of whole house retrofits and also the number of solid wall properties out there that also require insulating. So I think the government's taken this on board and have created Eco 4 with a bigger budget with the aim of supporting that whole house retrofit approach. Now, each of the obligations is based on the supplier market share. So effectively, E.ON at the moment is 20% of domestic energy customers. So therefore, we have 20% of the available funding to support those energy efficiency initiatives. Okay, so now we move on to Eco 4. So we've been delivering this through from April 2022 this year. This is the current obligation. And effectively, it's a fabric first, worst first approach to retrofit. And the aim of this obligation is to support 450,000 private sector households to reduce running costs, lower carbon emissions, and improve associated health outcomes. Ultimately, Eco can help people who can't necessarily afford the transition to net zero, and I think it's the first time really that whole house retrofit has been done at any type of scale, and certainly with any kind of budget behind it, certainly £1 billion. The budget has been increased significantly from the £640 million offered under Eco 3. So we'll look at the key points of the obligation and I'll move across one by one. So effectively, Eco 4 marks a move towards renewables and away from gas, with a cap on heating replacements set across the obligation period. So effectively, if you live in an electrically heated property now, the expectation is that you will benefit from an air source heat pump or some other kind of renewable heating install if you are eligible as part of a package of energy efficiency measures. In addition, there we have the new minimum requirement, and this means that a package of measures installed into an eligible property must achieve a two-band increase, for example, taking an EPC from an E to a C, and also the fabric of the building must be considered first before installing any other energy efficiency measures. So just making sure that the cavity wall is insulated. So we'll look at eligibility next. So people living in privately owned or rented properties can benefit from Eco 4 support as long as the EPC is rated D to G and one of the occupants receives a mixture of means tested benefits and or is on a low income. If you live in social housing, you qualify for support irrespective of your personal circumstances, subject to the property being EF or G rated. However, if the social housing property is D-rated, Eco support can be provided subject to the measures installed achieving innovation status. We've got a big target over the next 4 years. So across all obligated energy suppliers, we are required to achieve £224 million of annual bill savings for customers across the 4 year period, and that's against a budget of £4 billion to cover installation costs over that period. But like Previous obligations, energy suppliers will be required to install 90,000 solid wall measures across the obligation period. Again, this is a big challenge and was needed. We've installed a lot of locks and cavities over the previous years, so still a lot of solid wall installs to go in, a lot of solid wall properties that do need insulation. Up to 50% of the overall obligation target can be delivered through flex eligibility. This is where a customer meets a local authority's defined and bespoke eligibility criteria. In those circumstances, they will qualify. And local authorities can now use a new eligibility route, namely route 3 through flex eligibility, which means they can accept referrals from the NHS, clinical commissioning groups, and local doctors if someone is suffering from a list of cold-related illnesses, e.g. respiratory disease. In addition to this, rural uplifts will also be applied to measures installed in designated areas of Wales and also Scotland. This will improve funding for measures in these areas and will offset the disparity of other funding streams in England, namely HUG, Social Housing Decarb and LAD. These aren't currently available in Wales and Scotland. So now we'll move on to the social impacts of ECO. So what are the key outcomes from ECO? So it provides a number of positive social impacts. So EcoForce Fabric First Whole House Approach to Retrofit provides improved energy performance and obviously therefore thermal comfort. So a warm, efficient and well-ventilated property capable of retaining heat, reducing running costs for eligible households and tenants. As long as the customer is eligible, EcoFor does not require a financial contribution, so the obligation intention is to provide support for free, and the measures installed in properties will be free. And again, so that will support the most those not able to afford the transition to net zero. Measures installed through EcoFor hope that they'll provide better living conditions through reduced cold, damp and mould issues, which again can lead to respiratory disease. So hopefully reduce the pressure on the NHS and improve healthcare outcomes for eligible customers. And the community-based eco scheme focusing on a whole house retrofit approach contributes to local regeneration. So provides a sense of local pride really into the community. And ultimately lower running costs and lower carbon emissions where we've installed measures will contribute towards the UK's overall decarbonisation objectives over the next few years. So now we'll move on to delivery. So how we as E.ON deliver ECO as a scheme. So we've been working with RSLs and local authorities for a number of years across previous obligations and have the knowledge and the expertise in-house to design, develop and deliver energy efficiency schemes at scale. So looking at targeting, so who and where, firstly what we do is sit down with either the registered social landlord or the local authority and discuss their fuel poverty and net zero objectives and identify areas which may benefit from eco support. So typically these would be LSOA areas, deprived areas where people may meet that eco eligibility criteria. What we'll then review is the data, so using a range of kind of publicly available and E.ON specific data sources, we can review information at a property level to understand what energy efficiency measures the property requires to achieve the minimum requirement of a 2 SAT band increase. We can then begin to develop an area-based scheme focusing in on a worst-first approach with a view to maximising the deployment of ECO funding into the local community and the rollout of energy efficiency measures. Once we've mapped the data, we know what we're going and we know, you know, realistically who we can help, we'll then create a funding proposal. So once we've analysed all of the available data sources, we'll provide a fully costed eco funding proposal along with a delivery plan inclusive of marketing, call centre and also surveying resource. What we will say is funding is ring fenced, it's secure direct from an obligated energy supplier. And in addition, we are happy to explore and secure other external funding streams which can be used to interact with ECO and further kind of enhance the customer offer, whether this be HUG, Social Housing Decarb or LAD, We're currently working with a number of customers on these other funding streams, and it seems to be working really well. So upon agreement to proceed, we then work closely with the client to discuss kind of procurement and contracting requirements to ensure all parties are happy before we mobilise the scheme. So E.ON will manage the end-to-end customer journey from initial engagement to post-installation advice. And all of the work is carried out by our approved supply chain network, and wherever possible, we'll use local labour to support the delivery of the scheme. This contributes towards local job creation, and I suppose enhanced local and economic benefit. So we really do put the customer front and centre, and local community kind of regeneration front and centre of what we do. So thank you for listening. If you've got any questions, happy to answer those as part of our session. But if you'd like to contact me separately, my contact details are on the screen. Thank you very much.